Yeah.
Yes, sir. Woo.
Shade 4/5, man.
Shout out to Premier on this beat, you heard?
It's about that time. Relax, chill out. Take the pill, drink a wine. It's Shade 4/5 in this bitch. Can't wait to start the show and we can talk some shit. Come well equipped with motherfucking stories, lies, and bitches that are horny. Might tell the truth. Don't give a fuck. It's the all out show, nigga. That's what's up. Rude Jude on the west. And Lord Sear on the east coast, feeling on some breasts. Wanna suck a clit, but on the board, I can't do it to this chick. She got the lowest voice in America.
Why don't you leave her alone, Sear? Do your work and just shut up.
Man, listen, it's just Shade 4/5.
What?
Bugging out on the radio like this. 888 Shade 45, the toll free number to call right now. Yeah. Ladies, fellas, what? Truck drivers, around the world, it's time to get on now. We out of here. No, we just starting the show. Shade 45. Let's go.
Know what I mean? It's how we do right now. You know, all out show money through Friday. 4 to 8. It's like this, y'all. Clap your hands, y'all. It's like this, y'all. Come on. Come on.
Yeah. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Yeah. Shade 45, man. It is the all-out show. No, it is not. It is April Fool's Day. And you know what that means? Jude will not be here and Sam will not be here. April Fool's Day. It's for real. They both sick together. Get it? Someone is... Yeah, they both sick together. They took an April Day's Day, Fool Days off. That is wonderful. Smart to do. NHA45, got a good show today, a great show, got the ghetto music news, you know what I mean, definitely talk my shit, I put it down, got sports with Sear, you know what I mean, a lot of things going on in the sports, man. Spurs is cutting ass. I'm gonna talk about the Spurs, and that's my second team. I know my first team is New York Knicks, was all love, and got Takeover Tuesdays, shout out to Scott. It is Marvin Gaye's 30th anniversary, I guess, of his passing, right? Right. And we're going to be doing something special with the brother. We're going to play joints that was sampled by Marvin Gaye. I got a couple West Coast, East Coast, Down South classics, man, that I'm going to rock for y'all exclusively for Shade 45 for Marvin Gaye's 30th anniversary. That's a little bit later on. And then also, man, I got an early drunk mix, man. I got a lot of joints I want to get into, man. Exclusives, maybe some classic mixes, man. You know, getting your day going right. It is nice outside. Call up, man. Oh, I like that. That's an African beat. Da do do way. Sorry. Yeah. Oh, shit. Well, my niggas call. On that Instagram, on that Twitter, and on that Facebook, man, is Lord Sear. 888-742-3345. Up next is the Ghetto Music News, man. Don't go anywhere. All out show.
Lord Sear.
I'm the realest nigga in Harlem ever.
Known on the streets of Harlem as Stack Cheddar.
Man, fuck that nigga. I'm a real nigga, Stack Cheddar.
Bids include a 4-day stretch for hopping a subway turnstile.
Get your hands up.
Fuck 5-0.
From the only radio host gangster enough to report on the ghetto, it's Lord Sear with his ghetto music news.
It is April 4th. No, it's April 1st. Happy, what is the day? Oh, happy April Fool's Day. Great. It is the All Out Show. And in news today, Jurassic 5 announced word of mouth U.S. tour. That's right. Hey.
Next, we have a very big
turn on this mic. Join.
By the name of.
I like this. Hey. Shout out Jurassic 5. Damn, man. Newmark. Cut
camera.
I'm in tour. Hey. Yes. The Jurassic 5 reunion rolls on. The West Coast group is going to be doing a damn thing. July 7th, which is my birthday, will be in Vegas. Also in San Francisco. No, in Los Angeles, July 12th. Salt Lake City, July 15th. They're going to be in New York on August 2nd in New York at the Best Buy Theater. They're going to rock it. But the first show is in Vegas. Make sure you check that out. Good Brothers, classic music, Jurassic 5. Doing a damn thizzle, man. Turn up a little bit more. Damn. All right. Sorry about that, everybody. And in other news, I just found out that CeeLo Green, good brother of mine, man, shout out to CeeLo, man, will be replaced by Pharrell on NBC's The Voice as he fight an ecstasy suit. Man, what's going on with that, man? Hey, let me hear some happy. Because, you know, I ain't too happy for the brother CeeLo, man. Oh, shit, what you about to say, man? Next to his show, you're gonna be okay. Hey, hey. Hot air balloon that could go to space. With the air, like I don't care, baby, by the way. Because I'm happy. Well, CeeLo right now is going to court. Appears in Los Angeles over spiking a woman's drink with ecstasy back in July 2012. A preliminary hearing for the case is set for April 28th, near the end of season 6 of The Voice, his final season with the show. Oh man. And they already got pictures of The Voice already with them. And he's wearing a hat. He's not wearing Elmer Fudd's hat. I go get the Wabbit hat. He's not wearing a Wabbit hat. So it's all good. Shameful 5. Hey. Hey. Hey, Pharrell is happy because he got a new job. CeeLo is fucking up. He is happy. Everyone's happy, man. You should be happy also. And in other news, just found out that, what the hell happened again? Just found out that Straight Outta Compton will be coming out. Well, the casting call right now, Ice Cube. Rumor has it YG casting. We might be MC Ren. Might be, might not. Shout out to YG. I'm in stores right now. Casting is going on right now.
We're now about to witness the strength of street knowledge.
Street knowledge. Hey. Niggas with attitude, nigger. Fucking attitude, nigger. Straight out of motherfucking Compton. I hope we can film the Compton, man. You know what I mean? They might throw it in Canada. You know what I mean? I don't know where they're going to film it at, though. But, you know, if you want to be Ice Cube, if you want to be Eazy-E, if you want to be Dre, but you got to lift weights first, though. If you want to be Ice Cube, you might have to be chubby like me when I had the Jerry Curls and he was the Boys in the Hood. They might have cast Jerry Curls. I think Jerry Curls might be coming back soon, man. You know what I mean? Ice Cube was already said that he wants to play himself. Great. F. Gary Gray will direct the movie. Who he's famous for? Friday, the first movie. Friday was a classic, man. It started casting and all that started this summer, 2014. So for more info, go to Straight Outta Compton. I think .com, Straight Outta Compton. All Universal movie. To find out more info, man. Can't fuck with me. You better duck. It's crazy as fuck. When I do documentary, I'm crazy. Come Straight Outta Compton, motherfucker. And in other news, a sad, sad, sad story. Frankie Knuckles passed away at the age of 59. House legend. Representing Chi-Town, doing a damn thing. Known for this song right here, about to play. It was a club song. He was known for other dope stuff, like other ill mixes. He was great. He was classic, man. Damn, man. Frankie Knuckles, man. I was Chilling at the crib yesterday, going through some records, going through some joints. I was like, wow. That's sad, man. House legend, man. He was born in the Bronx, but migrated to Chicago when he became famous for doing the damn thing, man. He produced a lot of songs, man. He was the Cool Herc of house music. You know how Cool Herc is legendary for hip-hop. He was the Cool Herc of house music. Oh, man. They don't know of his, the nature of his death is unknown, but details are official, confirmed by Five Magazine. He passed away yesterday. Oh, man. Wow. Let us ride out for a little bit, man. That concludes the Ghetto Music News. Call it right now, 88Shade45. Hit me up on that Twitter, on the Instagram, and on the Facebook. Up next, it's Sports with Sear. All our show, I'll play some music, man. Let us ride for a little bit. April 1st, sports today. Tiger Woods is out of the Masters because of back surgery. Damn, Tiger, more white bitches and your back is fucking up. I think he fucked a black chick, that's why his back is fucked up. Probably a big chick. Now you gonna ride this pussy, nigga?
Like, I will, I'll try to.
I will, I'll try to sound like the Boondocks dude we had yesterday.
I will, but let me eat some tuna first, and then I'll fuck the shit out of you, you know? You better off just sucking my cock. I don't want to let Mary Jane know.
Yeah, well, he's out of the Masters, man. He's still making money, but damn, Tiger, what's wrong with you, man? He ain't been winning in a while either, man. I don't know. Fucking them hoes, I guess. And sports is here. Wale gets into a scuffle with the fan at the WWE Raw event. Wasn't that serious? It was over Twitter beef. Big fat husky white dude was like, dude, when I see you, it's on. You're gonna fight after I eat my cookies with my mom's and my little brother and wanna watch a naked man in tights wrestle, and I wanna fight you. So Wale took it serious. Wale, you making like 75 G's a show. You doing a damn thing. You went platinum. Almost platinum. Yeah, you went platinum because of fucking with Rick Ross. Come on, Wale. Grown ass man. Worried about a motherfucker. Twitter beef. I got beef to you on Twitter. Corny ass shit, man. You can't be doing that, man. Can't. Wale, just get your money and do the damn thing. Do the trance. Turn up. You're real. Express. So you can be on tour.
Trans Europe Express. Wale, what the fuck? Trans Europe Express.
Woman named Wale, and I like to fight fat white men and wrestle tonight. All right, and in other Sports is Here news, there's a good couple of games coming up today. Good matchups. Houston will be in Brooklyn tonight at 8 o'clock on TNT. Make sure you check that out. I'm going for Brooklyn in this one. I'm going for Houston in this one. Might be a little upset, but they in Brooklyn, so you never know. Brooklyn. Even though I'm a New York Knicks fan, shout out to Brooklyn. And also another game on the network. Golden State is at Dallas. I'm going for Golden State because they're young. They're doing the damn thing. Young Curry, he's going to kill him with the threes. Three popping little homie. You know what I mean? Stephen Curry going to cut their ass. That's at 8:30. And at 10:30, later on, after the Houston and Brooklyn game on the TNT channel, Portland Trailblazers will play the LA Lakers. Obviously, I'm going for Portland. Home of Nike. Portland is going to cut they ass, man. I don't have to the Lakers, man. I know I'm talking shit because the Lakers cut our ass. But that's all right, though, man. You know? But whatever, man. We got a great team, too, man. Shout out to Portland. That's at 10:30. For more information, go to SiriusXM.com/NBA. Go in there, man. Find out what's going on, man. Find out for more schedules, man. And what to do. And last but not least, man, TMZ.com reports LeBron raps about his yachts and things. And I know he can freestyle, man. I know he got a bad hairline, but I know he can freestyle. Let's play some of that audio right now. LeBron James, y'all. Exclusive.
Roll with us, cause you know cool. We got it. It's a damn shame that you ever doubted. Doubt it. Come roll with us, cause you know we got it. We got it. Roll with us, cause you know we got it. We got it. Roll with us, cause you know we got it.
LeBron James. We got it.
It's a damn shame that you ever doubted. Doubt it. It's a damn shame that you ever doubted.
Woo!
I just docked this up a friend's killer.
Damn.
Shots are bright, I got a tan killer.
My bad, ugly nigga though.
Try to catch up, it's a waste of time. I grind you hard, let you take mine.
Hey, yo!
Never.
AP watch drop next month.
Woo!
60 racks on your wrist to stunt.
Damn!
Stunt.
Fall back before you fall out.
Yeah.
My team eating the rest of y'all drought.
Drop.
Say what you want about the king. Got money, got cribs, got whips, and oh yeah, got two rings, cribs, tall like Costco's.
Woo.
Gotta keep getting that Robert De Niro. Don't fear, yo.
Yeah.
I understand you can't compete, bro. What you see here is royalty. You can't beat me. You better join me. Over 6 feet underneath.
Underneath.
My crown, she. Cause you know we got it.
Wait, hold on, man. Turn it down.
Roll
man,
with
LeBron.
Us, cause you know.
LeBron, you gonna end things gonna end up 6 feet? Everybody killing that. I thought you basketball play. You talking about you end up at 6 feet. Oh, damn, LeBron. You had it popping. But you talking about motherfuckers fuck with you, they gonna end up 6 feet. See, they laughing at you. King James. 88-45, man. That concludes Sports with Sear, man. Coming up next, man. Takeover Tuesdays, dedicated to Marvin Gaye. 30th anniversary. Let's go. It's Lord Sear, man. All out show. Take over Tuesday. It's where the intro. Oh, well. Yeah. Going to motherfucking 2003. 2014. Marvin Gaye. Passed away April 1st. Today, y'all, that's a funky man. Woo! He had joints for 30 years and still rocking. Oh, man, it ain't Shade 45, man. He died, today, April 1st, at age 44. We're talking about Marvin Gaye for Throwback. No, Takeover Tuesday. You say Throwback. Takeover Tuesdays, man, with Marvin Gaye. The 30th anniversary, man. Big shout to the homie. His real name was Marvin Pentes Gaye Jr. That's right. He was born in Washington, D.C. to Minister Marvin Gaye, Sir, and Alberta Gaye. He grew up in a house located on 1st Street and Southwest, only a few blocks away from the Anacostia River. He been doing the damn thing for a very, very, very long time. He began singing in church at the age of 4, accompanied by his father on the piano. His whole family, especially with his father, the church called the House of God. They were very, very intelligent. Had to go to church every day, almost every day, man. You know what I mean? His career started working with Bo Diddley. As you know, Bam Bam, of course, with the Columbia record. No, it started with OK Records with Bo Diddley. And had a group with the Moon Glows. That's right, 1959, promotional picture, man. He was a real brother, man. He did a damn thing, man. And he's in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Grammy Lifetime Achievement Award. Man, classic hits, man. Too many classics, man. Call it right now, 88-45. What was your favorite Marvin Gaye song? You know what I mean? Just call up and want to influence you with Marvin Gaye. We have a lot of people who listen to the station, especially older people, and, you know, our younger, especially younger generation that don't know who Marvin Gaye is. So, you know, definitely going to build you up to date and play samples. Let's play, let's get a real quick song called Sexual Healing. This joint came out in 1984. You know what I mean? One of his last hits before of his death. Let's see if we got that there. You got that? Play, I don't hear it in the background. There you go. Woo! That right there. Wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up. Oh, baby, don't let bed, don't be nah. Woo! This joint was hot!
Woo! Baby!
I'm what? Eric Sermon used this sample for I'm Hot, but he also used another Marvin Gaye sample. We're not going to get into it. We'll probably get into that a little bit later if we do have time. But we're going to play the sample of the person who used this joint, Sexual Healing. It was by Thuggish Ruggish Bone. The song is called First of the Month. Let's get into it right about now. Take Over Tuesdays. Dedicate to Marvin Gaye, 30th anniversary. Let's get into it right about now. Yeah. End up, get up, and deliberate. Shout out my Twitter peoples real quick, man. Pete Carey says, Lord, see, you did that Marvin Gaye intro. All right. And shout out to Bo Shade. You know what I'm saying? Always on the check-in. Right now in the background, you're hearing a Marvin Gaye classic, Funky Reincarnation. Instrumental part, man. Oh, no. That's something totally different, brother. All right. Don't. Why not too yet, man? 30th anniversary, man, of Marvin Gaye for Take Over Tuesdays. Call it right now and let me know what favorite song, what motivates you. Marvin Gaye, jump off. We are not taking requests, please. We're not taking requests. What Marvin Gaye song had your ass get out the house, get you dancing on? What song made you grow up? What song made you fuck a chick raw? Baby, you can call up. And what made you have them kids from a Marvin Gaye song? Because Marvin Gaye produced a lot of babies. Let's go to line one real quick. Hey, Zach.
What's up, man?
What's going on, brother?
How you doing, brother?
What's your favorite Marvin Gaye song, man?
Got to give it up, man. Got to give it up.
Yeah, man. That's the joint Robin Thicke used. Well, kind of, well, he didn't use it. Well, Pharrell played it the same way. It's different drums, but the patterns are the same. And his daughter, Nona Gaye, ended up suing.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
Yeah, Robin Thicke. I think she won or something, you know, undisclosed what, as far as, like, what money she got from it. But,
right.
You know, yeah, that song, well, that joint was really hot, man.
Yeah, man. The first time I ever heard it was in the movie Barbershop. And I was like, damn, that song is hot.
Yeah, that. Marvin Gaye, man, gets you dancing, man.
Hell yeah.
That's right. Thanks for calling, Zach.
Yeah, man, thanks for listening.
No problem. G, New Mexico, G.
What up?
What up, though?
Yo, my favorite Marvin Gaye song is Let's Get It On.
Ah, see, for the chicks.
Hell yeah, gotta make some babies do that shit.
That's what, like I just said, it was baby-making songs, man. Marvin Gaye definitely got it on with the hoes, man. You gotta see him perform it on Soul Train on YouTube, man. He was really killing it, man.
Oh, I'm going to have to go look that up.
Yeah, he was killing it, man. Thanks for calling, G.
Yeah, no problem.
All right. 88 Shade 45. This is what we're going to do, man. Let's get into a joint now. See, not only Marvin Gaye did joints with Tammy Terrell and other people, but later on in the 70s, he wanted that feel again. You know what I mean? When he was doing songs with Ain't Nothing Like the Real Thing and whatnot. He did a whole album with him and Diana Ross, which is very official. You need to download it or, you know, on Amazon.com. It's called Marvin and Diana. Let's play a song called Stop Looking, Listen, where they took it from the Stylistics. The original, but they sung it over. Let's play it real quick. Hey. Yeah. Now, the rapper who used this song, good friend of ours still. Know what I mean? 50 Cent used this for a ghetto Kwan, which he broke down Queens drug dealers and the streets. Ooh. Wait, play this in the beginning. Play this in the beginning real quick. Yeah. He was the beginning. part and kept it going. You know what I mean? Uh-huh. 888-45. Call him right now, and this is Throwback Tuesdays. Throwback? He's going to take over Tuesday. He's saying throwback. Same shit. Take over Tuesdays with the man, the myth, the magnificent Marvin Gaye's 30th year of his passing. Let's go into it right now. It's Lord Sear, All Out Show. Let's play 50 Cent, Ghetto Kawan, and we'll be right back. Call up and let me know what was one of your favorite Marvin Gaye songs. Let's go. Shade 45. Uh-huh. Again. Hey. Uh-huh. Take over. Taking over Tuesdays with Lord Sear right here on the All Out Show. 30th anniversary for Marvin Gaye. Just heard 50 Cent, Ghetto Kawan. He used the sample Stop Looking, Listen to Your Heart from the Diana and Marvin album. Yeah. Amazon that. This in the background, what you hear? Fucking Reincarnation, the instrumental. See, where'd you get that? Don't worry about it. It's a Marvin Gaye song. Hey. All right. We're going to go to phone lines and let me know what Marvin Gaye song inspired you, what kept it going. Why was this man a genius? Why he produced and played a lot of songs and wrote a lot of joints also. You know what I mean? Helped out Stevie Wonder, co-writer and producer with Smokey Robinson on the Motown label. Shout out everybody out there in the D. You know what I mean? Let's go to phone lines. And there's a lot of people still on hold, man. Let's speak to Bill, Mississippi. Bill.
What's going on, Blair?
What's going on, man?
Nah, shit, man. My favorite Marvin Gaye song is going to be that I heard it through the grapevine.
Okay. All right. Well, why was that your favorite song, man?
Man, that song just go hard, man. I liked it when the Temptations did it, too, but Marvin Gaye did it the best, though.
Marvin Gaye was one of the first. He had the host throw panties at him on stage, man.
Yeah.
God damn. They were probably funkier back then. But it was all good, though.
Yeah.
My nigga Bill, man. Thanks for calling, man.
No problem, bro.
All right. Jalil.
Yes, sir. How you going?
How you going, brother? What's going on? Call from Georgia, man. What's your favorite Marvin Gaye song?
Yes, sir. It has to be What's Going On.
All right. Now, why was one of your favorite songs?
Yes, sir. See, I'm a 90s baby. You know, I'm just 22.
Okay.
But, you know, yes, sir. But when you listen to the artist of now, that I grew up listening to, like when Tupac said, you know, I remember Marvin Gaye used to say to me, he had a feeling like black was a thing to be. Or, you know, when James said, I want to know what's going on, like there, Mark, that really let me know from a young age that Marvin Gaye was a positive impact.
Yes,
you know,
sir.
And then, but man, you need to play that joint, just like music.
The only things that we do not take requests. Thank you for calling. Let's go to the phone lines. Damon in Louisville. Damon.
Yo,
what's up? What's up, brother?
Man, I Want You. You can play the song or the whole album. It don't matter. If you want to chill out and get mellow, you play that from front to back and you be where you want to be.
That get the bitches crying and fucking, too.
Yes, it will. Draws down and then you're on.
God damn it, man. And, Damon, thank you for calling on that. No, man, let's play some of that I Want You in the background, man.
Yeah.
We're going to play that for that nigga, Damon. You know what I mean? Turn up. I heard him already. Sound like he was busting a nut. And play from the beginning. Play from the beginning. Why, Scott? Play from the beginning. Why does it sound like he busting a nut? Listen. Damn, Mom, you nasty, nigga. Woo! Nobody could not fuck with this album, man. It's changed the whole realm, the whole spectrum of the God, you know. Marvin was just, damn. What you got to do is buy this deluxe album on CD on Amazon.com. The double CD, which it has instrumentals and acoustic versions, acapellas, you know what I mean? It turned up a little bit. Hey. Also, you got to see him perform this on YouTube, where he is just laying down on a couch while the band is performing it. Like, you know, backstage, like, you know, in practice performing it. He got a sweatsuit on with, like, I guess he had the flu or the cold, whatever, and was just killing it singing, like laying on the couch. It's impeccable, man. That's a funny looking niggas with dreads. Funny motherfuckers playing dreads, playing drums, looking crazy. The next joint we're going to play from this sample, who used it, is I Want You by Joe Buttons, produced by Just Blaze, a track way back. Let's do it, man. Shade 45, Marvin Gaye. Take over Tuesday. Yeah. All right, 88 Shade 45, take over Tuesdays. Marvin Gaye edition, man. It's been 30 years since he passed, man. 30 years, 30 long years. Wow. We're doing this, man, because it's 30th anniversary, man. Call it right now. What is one of your favorite songs that inspired you from Marvin Gaye? No, we're not taking requests. And don't tell me what to play. Just talk about it, be about it. It's Shade 45, man. Let's go speak to Thompson, Idaho. Thomas!
What's up, man?
What's going on, man? What's your favorite Marvin Gaye song?
The Sexual Healing, man.
Okay.
Oh, man. I play that shit whenever I have a girl over. It's perfect, man. It's chill. It sets the mood. Pour a little Chardonnay. Fuck, man. It's perfect.
Chardonnay. All right.
Hell yeah, man.
That's what's up, man.
Oh, what's up, yeah. <All
right>. Thanks for calling, man. It's sounding horny. That's, Taking another call, DJ Cisco.
What's up, baby? It's DJ Cisco, Brooklyn, coming to you. Listen, Marvin Gaye was political, and he could be provocative and sexy. With Mercy, Mercy Me, he talked about everything that's going on right now, actually, 30 years ago, and then he could take you over to, like, Sexual Healing. Now, listen, at the end of Sexual Healing, it says, please don't procrastinate. It's not good to masturbate. Mm-hmm. Have you ever caught that?
Yes.
Okay.
And
okay.
I jerked off today in the shower. I'm sorry, Marvin.
And you are absolutely right. That version of I Want You on YouTube is hot to death.
He destroyed it, man.
He destroyed it. He was laying down just chilling. And they added like an extra beat to the beginning, man. Yo, and does anyone compare? Like, I feel sorry for these kids nowadays. Does any artist out here currently, can any artist compare to Marvin Gaye?
I mean, to tell you the truth, R&B to me, listen, R&B died with its originality between the mid, like, early 90s, because you knew whose voice was what. You knew who Glenn Jones was. You knew who Freddie Jackson, Luther Vandross, you know what I mean? The list goes on and on.
But you're missing one key element. Mm-hmm. The instrumentation died because they were using bands, they were musicians. All of those artists that you just named were using drum machines, studio sounds, all that bullshit. And I love your show. I know you guys are hip-hop, and I'm glad that you're paying homage to the late, great Marvin Gaye, man.
That's how we do it, man. It's Lord Sear doing the damn thing. You heard me?
DJ Cisco out, baby.
All right. Let's speak to Mike in Tampa. Hi, Mike.
Hey, what's going on? It's Mike in Tampa.
All right, what is your favorite Marvin Gaye song?
Well, so my song's got a deep memory to it because my wife and I got married to at our wedding. The song was "Let's Stay Together."
Are you sure Marvin Gaye sung that song?
Let's stay together.
That was Al Green, Mike.
Oh man.
Sorry, Mike. You fucking up the whole shit. You can't be serious. Wait, we have someone. They also have a favorite song. Kay and Callie. Kay. Hello? Dumbass? All right. Let's keep this going, man. One more call. D&DCD.
Yo, what up, man? I just wanted to comment on one of my favorite Marvin Gaye joints, which was Trouble Man. It was one of them songs that kept me pushing, bro.
Yes.
He was like the activist in the music business. And him being from the same city I'm from, I love that song. They also had a movie. that was inspired by the song Trouble Man 2.
Yeah, you can buy that on Amazon. You might catch it on Netflix, I doubt it, but yeah, that was a classic too, brother.
Yeah, it's a real old school joint, and that's one of my songs I be feeling when I'm going through it, you know, when you feel like you're alone. That's one of them songs that'll get you through, bro.
Mm-hmm. When you alone, I hear you. 88 Shade 45. This is what we're going to do, man. Let's get to a Marvin Gaye song called Inner City Blues. Let's play some of that real quick. It's a hood classic. Oh, man. Whoa. This is going through, through the war. Definitely dedicated to the war, Vietnam, the ghettos of America, and all over the world. This is a very inspiring song. Let's play something. Listen to some of the lyrics real quick. Organ horns. I mean, like, seriously, some... And living color. You can do that's what it sounds like. Shade 45, man. We are talking about Marvin Gaye, Takeover Tuesdays. It's 30th anniversary of him passing, man. You can YouTube a lot of his performances. Also, his older performances. Similarities to Sam Cooke, they sang from back in the days. Rumor has it that he stole or tried to look as smooth as Sam Cooke, but couldn't get it. You know, Sam Cooke died early in the 60s. Sam Cooke was incredible. Yeah, man, he did the damn thing. Let's go to Manny in Brooklyn. Manny, what up, homie?
Yo, what's going on, brother? How's everything?
Yes, sir. Doing well. How you doing, sir?
I'm good. No, I'm just going because I just want to say I saw Marvin Gaye. He's one of the best singers alive, man. All them little motherfuckers that don't know shit about him, fuck them.
Yeah.
My nigga right there. Fuck all that shit, nigga. Fuck all them youngins. Don't play that shit. Marvin Gaye, that's my nigga. That's my motherfucking nigga, all
right? Yeah, Manny.
All I got to say, brother, all right? Take care, man. One love. Say 4-5.
No doubt, nigga. Manny, man. Wow. Okay. K and Cali K.
Hey.
Hey, what's up, baby? How you doing?
I'm good. And yourself?
Just over here, man, talking about Marvin Gaye, the myth, the living legend.
It is wonderful, right? Yeah. I'm only 25, but my parents is real OG style. So, you know, the old school really gets me. You know, my grandma, you know, I'm a grandma's baby, too. So how sweet it is to be loved by you, though. How sweet is it to be loved by you, Sear?
I know, man. You know, that's what I'm saying. If we were together right now, I'd be singing it in your ear. You know what I mean? Look, you know what I mean? How sweet it is to be loved by you. Like, you know, I wasn't singing.
Hey!
I wasn't singing. Now, I ain't got no look at me, but, you know, I definitely sing to
you. I do.
You
know. I'm fresh off work, fresh out of school. Yep.
Damn. Gotta come out to Cali one day, man. I'm gonna try to do it this year, man, around July. You
gotta
know.
Come to the Bay. You don't just come to California, you come to the Bay.
Oh, I definitely gotta come out to the Bay, man. Shout out Souls of Mischief, E40, my people's out there, you know. Definitely, man. Definitely gotta come out to the Bay. Do it a day.
Hey. Man, okay, now.
All right, Kay, thank you for calling and bigging up Marvin Gaye. You know what I'm saying? Call him anytime.
Okay, I always will whenever I get a chance.
All right, baby.
All right.
Peace. Lauren.
Hello.
Hey.
I listen all the time. So excited to be on the air.
All right. We talking about Marvin Gaye. What's going on?
Well, I've been listening to Marvin since I'm 31, and I have all my dad's old vinyl records of Marvin Gaye. He is my favorite.
Okay.
So I listen to the real deal.
Oh, you better listen to the real deal. Shit, I got 45s in them too. Nothing.
Hey, me too. I'm with you.
Yeah. We gotta hang out one time. Let's go through some records. You know what I mean?
My record collection, I got over 400 records. Whenever you want to do it, let's do it.
Let's do it. If you're on that Facebook, I'm on there. You know what I mean?
All right, I'll look you up.
That's where I get a crack at. Lord Sears on that prompter. Holla. All right. Thank you for calling, baby.
All right. Thanks.
All right. Let's go to, hey, Jamal.
Yo.
What up, Jamal?
Hey, not too much. Mine is a sleeper. Everybody's kind of named off all the basics of everything that we know. But I was an athlete, and then when this hit in the 80s, and he sung the national anthem for the Lakers, mm-hmm. Completely shut it down, caught everybody off guard. It was like it wasn't even a national anthem. It was so hot. And
he made it soulful. You know what I mean? Like how everybody had to be very petite, very Americanized. He made it like, You know, dogs, I'm recording this soul right now, getting everybody my soulful thing. You know, he was killing it.
That, and I cracked up. They made a video out of it, and there's an extended version to it. It's, like, completely ridiculous. That's one of the smoothest joints I've ever heard.
Well, I think we might have some of that audio here. Let me see if we got some of that. Hold on now. We might have some of that audio. It is Shade 45. Turn down a little bit. We have another caller who says they like a Marvin Gaye song before we get back to the hip-hop. Hey, Brian, ATL Brian.
Hey,
what's going on, man? What's your favorite Marvin Gaye song?
Oh, man, I think Everybody Plays a Fool. I haven't heard anybody bring that one up.
You fucking asshole, Brian. That's by the main ingredient, Cuba Gooding's father. Sorry. Goodbye, Brian. For fucking up the segment. And anyway, let's speak to Calabili. What's your name, man?
Caleb.
How you doing, Caleb?
Yeah, I'm good, man. Great. Huge fan of you and Jude, man. Love y'all, show.
Thank you, man. Thank you, man.
Yeah. But real quick, I'm only 21, so I'm young and whatnot. But I remember, like, first time hearing Mercy Me, my parents showed me. They're from South Side of Chicago, and felt like that song just stuck in my head. I love Mercy Me, man.
You know what? And on that note, man, thank you for calling, man. And on that note, let's get into some of the Mercy Me. Mercy Me. Marvin Gaye classic right here. Hey. Woo. It ain't Shade 45, man. Got to do that, man, for the homie. Shot in the comment. Shot town in the building. Yeah, man. Let's go to phone lines. And let's speak to Jennifer. Jennifer.
What's going on?
What is... Oh, damn, man. What you sounded... What's up, baby? What's up, baby?
Ain't nothing going on my way home from work and heard you on the radio talking about one of my favorite people and wanted to pay a little homage to him.
All right. Now, what song did you like from Marvin Gaye?
You can leave, but it's going to cost you.
Now, do you know what album is that from?
Love and something, I don't know, but I just love that song.
Well, you know what the purpose of that album is about, right?
Yeah, he and his wife going through some stuff, and he just laying it down on the, telling her what's it going to be about and what's life going to be like.
It was a divorce album, because what it was.
Right.
It was called Hear My Dear, and what it was that when he recorded that album, 100% of the publishing went to her, and he thought it wasn't going to sell. It ended up selling 3-4 platinum.
Yeah, and she got paid off of it,
but that whole album is magnificent, though. They brought it back out again a couple of years ago, a double CD with interludes, remixes, unheard stuff. So if you want to cop it again, you know, they definitely put some more stuff in it, too. Shout out Easy Mo B, this stuff on there, Questlove. You know, remixes is dope. It's dope, Jennifer.
Don't have that, but hey, that's my favorite.
You better go cop it, girl. That's what I'm talking about. Jem is representing M-Town.
There you go.
Good for that barbecue. Right. Can you cook?
No, I can't.
All right, but it's all good.
I have a husband to do that, and if I leave, it's going to cost me.
Well, you better go back that nigga right now and go back over here.
All right,
Jennifer. AJ 45. Let's start Marcus in Brooklyn. Marcus.
Yo, what up?
What it do, man?
Nothing much, man. My favorite song from him is a song that a lot of people don't know about. It's called T Plays It Cool.
Oh, you talking about the breakbeat right there?
Yeah, a lot of people sampled it. And he's not only a great songwriter, singer, but he actually played the instruments on that, except for the horn. He played everything on that.
Yes, he did. Brother. That was off of the Trouble Man soundtrack. And what you need to do also... You need to buy the Trouble Man. They brought it back out the anniversary. It's a double CD, and it's ill because it has unreleased joints that were played from the album that are on the second CD that's unreleased and unheard of, and a different and different alternate versions of T Plays It Cool.
Oh, get out. I'm going to definitely pick that up.
Yeah, definitely. It's not He Plays It Cool, man. It's T Plays. And look, you looking at me with that?
Yeah, T Plays It Cool.
Well, all for that Trouble Man soundtrack. Definitely, man. Shout out to Breakbeat Lou, King of the Breakbeats. Ultimate Breakbeats 1 through 25 will be out soon. Know what I mean? Ooh. All right,
thanks for the recommendation, brother.
No problem, no problem. 8-8-Shade-45. Let's speak to Chris of Tennessee. Chris.
Hey, what's going on, sir?
All right, what's your favorite Marvin Gaye song?
Man, Distant Lover.
Distant Lover? Okay, okay. What you like about that song?
What'd you say?
What'd you like about that song, man?
Man, I think everybody can relate to that. Like, when I got out of school, man, you know, you go off to college and everything, you might be feeling the tick or whatever, then... You know, you're trying to get what you put that on. You're thinking about it, you know?
Mm, okay, okay. Let's play some of that Distant Love in the background real quick. And we got to play that for the ladies. Oh, man. I was born. Wait a minute. My mama had sex on that year. God bless. Oh, your mom was born. Okay. Yeah, me and your mom was born same year, 1973. God damn. This is love. That's why I came in at the house. Oh. I was like, God damn, mama, turn that off. She said, no. Shade 45. The last joint I'm going to play for. For the segment, this joint's called Is That Enough? There's a Marvin Gaye joint from the Hear My Dear album. Let's hear some of it. Yeah, this is for real, right? Get right, yeah. Where the fuck is the music, man? Hello? Take your time, I can hear a bit, I can talk over it. Waiting for music. Oh, hey, back to Marvin Gaye again. All right. Marvin. Moonshots. It's the drug mix. Up next. Ah, the drug mix is up next. Shade 45. Exclusives. Maybe some new joints. Maybe some album cuts. Maybe some classics. I'm playing some soulful shit, man. Hit me up on that Twitter and let me know what you're sipping on. You can hit me up on the Twitter also and let me know what you're sipping on there. And also, you can hit me up on the phone lines, 888-742-3345. If you'd like to be heard live, you know, I know y'all motherfuckers driving and chilling with the crew. Or maybe some bitch dissed you and played you out. Said you ain't shit. Or you be a fat motherfucker like me, everybody just up that they hate and want to diss me. Well, then fuck you, nigga. You still call up. Like, what's up, Sear? What up, nigga? What you sipping on? My hand? You know what I'm saying? Like, got Scott here doing the boards with the Carhartt. I remember I had the, a Carhartt jacket in 90-something. I can't believe they still make Carhartt. That's what's up, though, man. J45 up next is the drop mix. Hit me on that Facebook. Also, hit me up on that Twitter, at Lord Sear. And Instagram. I'm about to put up some more funk 45s for you, man. It's in demand. People been talking, you know what I mean? Color producers want to work with me, man. If you want to work with Lord Sear, I have the email coming up very soon. And hit me up on that SoundCloud. And I have a Tumblr. A Tumblr, DJ Lord Sear. Scott helped me out 2 years ago. With a Tumblr. DJ Lord Sear. Just type that up, DJ Lord Sear Tumblr. And let's play some music. Come right back. Drunk Mix is up next. Shade 45. Let's go.